WNEM TV5 News Update.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Raven Bloom. Here's a look at the top stories we're following tonight. Saginaw police officers are getting a new tool to help them better respond to calls for people struggling with mental illness. The new program called Crisis Connect will roll out this week. It comes from a grant from the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services. iPads will be used to help in their responses to calls for domestic and mental crises. Officials hope the iPads will help de-escalate some tense situations. The goal is to expand this service for 24/7 use and to expand it to the entire Saginaw Police Department and eventually other departments within the county. Crime Stoppers is offering a cash reward of up to $2,500 for any information that helps track down the person responsible for an unsolved murder. 1 year ago, 31-year-old Laquavius Williams was shot and killed in his car at the intersection of Avenue A and East Baker Street in the city of Flint around 6:30 p.m. on March 24th. Investigators say Williams stopped his vehicle at the intersection and was hit by several bullets. The suspect's vehicle was a white Jeep Liberty. If you have any information, you can call Crime Stoppers anonymously. Tune in to TV5 Plus tonight to watch the Saginaw Spirit take on the Gowelliff Storm at the Dow Event Center. This is the fourth and final matchup between the two teams. The Spirit has won all previous games against the Storm. The team says the players to watch tonight are Lincoln Moore, Hunter Height, Matthias Sapovalov, Dean Locus, and Michael Misa. The puck drops at 7:05. Now here's Chris with a look at your forecast.
In a messy system earlier today, not done with us just yet, but thankfully from this point forward, snowfall accumulation should be pretty light. So your Saturday evening plans, while this will be a nuisance, it's not expected to really ruin anything as far as travel goes. Obviously drive to conditions, but it's something that's going to force you to stay home. That doesn't appear to be the case. Our traffic map this afternoon looks pretty good. We've got green just about everywhere. That may change a little bit here and there tonight, but as far as anything major, that doesn't appear to be the case. Our system will continue pulling away from us off to the north and east. The second half of the weekend should be much drier. Our skies will likely clear out a little bit as we head into the overnight. The only exception could be our counties to the north, where lake effect clouds may linger a little bit longer. And then as we go through the day on Sunday, maybe a mixed sky. Some areas seeing a bit more sun than others, but it looks like we stay dry most of the day. There will be a small chance for a little bit of rain and snow late Sunday night into early Monday. So far, that not expected to be a huge issue. How much snow accumulation from this point forward? Not a ton, less than an inch just about everywhere. If anyone sees anything over that, it should be around the far northern areas closer to the winter storm warning. Low temperatures tonight will settle in the 20s. We do have a wind advisory, and that will gust near 40 to 45 miles per hour, so our wind chills will likely be much cooler, but we do expect those winds to drop off quite a bit as we head into the overnight hours, and eventually by tomorrow morning, wind gusts are only between 15 and 20. Your 7-day forecast shows early next week we're mainly dry Monday and Tuesday. Temperatures in the 40s most of the week, warmer by the end of the week.
Remember to tune into WNEM TV5 on air and online 24/7 for the latest news, weather, and information.